Concentration acid means concentration of hydronium ions and concentration of hydroxyl ions are present. So their product that is equal to concentration of hydronium ions in water. Hydronium is acid, so its value is how much? Hydronium last class. Hydronium ion is H3O+. That is equal to 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7 moles per liter. Is it? And similarly, hydroxyl ion concentration. So 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7 moles per liter. Is it? Their product, because they are both present in water, their product that is equal to the, so 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7 into 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7. So 1 into 1, 1 only. So here, bases are same, we can add the exponents. So 10 to the power of minus 14 mole square per liter square. You see, so this is the ionic product of water, ionic product of water. So that is represented by Kw, ionic product of water. So ionic product of water, what is that? It is the product of concentration of hydronium ions and concentration of hydroxyl ions in the water. Okay, so that is called ionic product of water. So 1 liter into the power minus 14 mole square per liter square. Can you hear my voice? Yes, sir. You should tell something, otherwise I am not getting anything. I felt that some because of the network problems you are not talking. I felt that, okay? So please start in the middle there. It means don't have unwanted things. If I ask a question, give some answers for that one, okay? Now, move to the day I told you last class regarding about the pH scale, is it? So before going to the pH scale, on adding acid to the water, so whose concentration get increases? Is hydronium ion concentration get increases or hydroxyl ion concentration get increases? On adding acid to the water, whose concentration is going to increase? Is hydronium ions or hydroxyl ion concentration?
Hydronium ion.
Yes. So hydronium ion concentration is going to increase, whereas hydroxyl ion concentration is going to what? Increase or decrease? Decrease. Yes, keep in mind that. So if you add acid to the water, hydronium ion concentration is going to increase, whereas the hydroxyl ion concentration is going to decrease. It means that they are getting neutralized. They are going to become the neutralized. Similarly, so if you add base to the water, so whose concentration is going to increase? If you add base to the water, which concentration is going to increase? Can you hear my voice? Yes. Hydroxyl ion concentration is going to increase. Okay, so keep it in mind there. Next, as I told, pH scale. So the pH scale is, so what is the use of the discovery of the pH scale? So to get the accurate value, okay, to get the accurate values of acids and bases, they discovered the pH scale, that is discovered by Danish biochemist, his name is Sorensen. Discovered pH scale to determine the accurate values of acids and bases. Okay. Determine the accurate value. You have to find the accurate value. You know that? So few test tubes you do, it means a litmus paper is there. There if you observe color change, it means from red to blue, you will say it is a base, and blue to red, it is an acid. But we will not get the accurate value. What is the value that we should not get there? So to determine the accurate value, PH scale is determined. So by whom it is discovered? By Sorensen. He is Sorensen is a biochemist. Is a biochemist. So Sorensen discovered the pH scale to determine the accurate values of acids and bases. So what stands for pH? pH stands for what? So P stands for potenza. So in German, what is that? So he is a German scientist. So potenza is nothing but power. Okay. So potenza, it means power. So H. So in pH, H means power of hydrogen. So pH is called power of hydrogen. The given solution. Power of hydrogen in the given solution. Okay. So pH. Power of hydrogen. pH stands for power of hydrogen. Okay. Then how to define pH? The pH of a solution. pH of a solution is a negative logarithm to the base 10 of the hydrogen ion concentration expressed in moles per liter. So pH of a solution is defined as pH of a solution is a negative logarithm to the base 10 of the hydrogen ion concentration. Per moles per liter. So that is the pH. So pH of a solution is determined. So how to define it? One. So pH of a solution is defined as it is a negative logarithm to the base 10 of the hydrogen ion concentration. And it is expressed in moles per liter. So I will write it in board together. So pH. So now let me say for now how to represent in a numerical form. So pH that is equal to log 10 1 divided by H hydrogen ion concentration. That is equal to the so negative logarithm now. So minus sign should write it. Minus log 10 H plus. So pH of a solution is a negative logarithm of the base 10. Of a hydrogen ion concentration. H plus hydrogen ion concentration. That is expressed in moles per liter. So pH of a solution is the negative logarithm to the base 10. Negative logarithm to the base 10 of hydrogen ion concentration. Okay. So that is expressed in a unit moles per liter. Okay, so this is the definition of the pH of a solution. So as I told pH scale ranges. So its reading ranges from 0 to 14. So pH scale is now. So its range is from 0 to 14. pH scale range 0 to 14. So 0 to 0. 0. 0 to 14. 0 to 14. Okay. So here 7 indicates neutral. So neutral means what? If the reading came neutral. It means what? It means what? Neutral means what? It is a salt. It is a salt. Can you hear my voice? Can you hear my voice? Yes. Still something. While asking, why you are simply sitting there in front of the phone sitting, what you are doing, meditation or whatever, you know. So, pH, it is a neutral, it means it is a salt. Okay. It is a salt. Okay. So, 7 to the left side. If you move the readings, if it comes 7 to the left side, it indicates they are acids. They are acids. It means 7 to the left side are target. 7 to the left side. It means 0 to 6.9. 0 to 6.9. So in the pH scale, the reading came between 0 to 6.9. It indicates they are acids. They are acids. Okay. So as you move to the left side, their acidic character are going to increase. Their acidic character are going to acidic increase. Acidic character going to increases. Okay. So 7 to 14. It means from 7.1 to 14. That indicates bases. That indicates bases. So if the reading came 7.1, 7.3. Okay. So from 7.1 to the 14 indicates they are bases. Bases. Okay. So to the 7 to the right side. So it is a bases. Indicates base. And 7 to the left side. It is a acid. If 7 came, it is a neutral, it means it is a salt. Okay, so it is a salt. Salt. So, and one more thing, so if you move, so if the solution pH scale reading came, 1, 2, 3, they are strong acids. So, reading pH scale, if it comes 1, 2, 3, they are considered as strong acids. So as move towards the nearest to the 7, it means 5, more than 5, 5.5, 6, 6.5, 6.8, they are weak acids. They are considered as weak acids. Clear? Any doubt is there?
No, sir.
Yes. So closer to the 0, closer to the 0. So 1, 2, 3. So almost closer to the 0. So they are strong acids. Okay, closer to the 7, that means the weak acids. Weak acids. Clear? Next, similarly, 7 to 14. 7 to 14. So, if 7.5, 8, 9, 10, they are weak bases. Weak bases. If their value goes on, increases from 7 to the right side. So, it means 12, 13, 14. They are strong bases. They are considered as strong bases. So if you move to the right side of the summit, their alkaline nature is going to increase us. It means base. Alkaline means base. They are going to increase us. Their value is going to increase us. Summit to the right side. Summit to the left side. Acid, summit to the right side. Base. This is regarding about the pH scale. Okay. Clear? Any doubt is there regarding about the pH scale? Yes, now I will go to the next one. Universal indicator. Universal indicator. Only before coming to the universal indicator, we learned 3 indicators. That is litmus, beta orange, and phenolphthalein. So one more indicator, that is universal indicator. Universal indicator. Universal indicator. So what is the universal indicator? So universal indicator is a mixture of indicator dyes. Mixture of indicators of dyes. In dyes you see different colors, is it? different different colors. Dyes that gives a that dye universal indicator is a mixture of indicator dyes that gives a spectrum of color changes. Spectrum of color changes depending on how acidic or alkaline a solution is. So universal indicator so goes on will change the colors. It will goes on changing the color. If you take the color as liquid, so if it is a neutral. It means a neutral means the pH scale reading 7. So some acidic. If you add some acidic substances, so if the pH scale reading comes 5, so its color will be yellow. Its color will be yellow. Okay. Still, if you are adding more acidic substances, it will the pH scale reading comes 3. So it indicates pink color. It gives the pink color. Okay. So similarly, so pH scale reading comes 1. So red in color. Red in color. So colors is going to changes. So as the acidic character increases, so its color going to change. Similarly, basic alkalinity character is going to increase as now. So colorless liquid is a neutral or soft. So you are adding base. You are adding base only little or 5 gram will add there. So its pH scale reading comes 9. So that indicates blue. So pH scale reading comes 9. So it changes to a blue color. Okay. So some more alkaline liquid base will add there for that solution. So its value getting increases. So pH scale reading 11 will comes there. So that time its color will be indigo. Indigo. So you can look at your textbook there, page number 47. If you open keep the textbook, you can see there. So how the colors will changes there for different readings, how the colors will changes there. Color changes in the universal indicator for different pH values. Is it? It is there, page number 47. You can go through that one. So that is it regarding about the universal indicator. So as the acidic character, our basic character goes increases in the color solution, so their reading, their color also changes. As the reading changes, their color also going to change. That's why it considered the universal indicator. Universal indicator. So this is about the universal indicator. Next, coming to the point. Next, now importance of pH in everyday life. Importance of pH in everyday life. Let's see one by one. So many importance are there from the pH. pH in our life also. So what is the importance? The first one. So our body pH should be in the range of 7 to 7.8. 7 to 7.8. Body pH range. The most important, so the rain you see daily rain is it if the pH range it comes below 5.6 second one
gastric, I don't know. Excess of acid is produced.
So what is required, that much only produced, there is no drawback from the acid. So more excess acid is secreted in the stomach, so that will leads to the some other disease. It means gastric, is it irritation, stomach pain, that and all will happen there. Is it? So how to reduce that one? How to reduce that one? So how to reduce? By using the base, magnesium, hydroxide, antacids. I told you last class, antacids. So if you use a antacid, that is magnesium hydroxide, antacid. Magnesium hydroxide that acts as a base antacid, it means they will neutralize the solution. It means if more acid is produced, so if you add the base, it will neutralize this. Is it? It will neutralize this. It means the pH value becomes to 7. Okay. So to reduce that one. So if excess of acid is produced in the stomach, to reduce that one, there is the antacids, magnesium hydroxide, that is one of the antacids. Okay, so that will neutralizes the acid. Okay, next one more, the sixth use of the pH. So tooth decay will happen in the mouth, is it? Tooth decay. Yes sir. So what is the reason why it will happen there?
Sir, if we eat so much chocolate and sweets.
Yes, if you eat so much chocolates and sweets, so that time will tooth decay will happen there. It means, so some bacteria are present there in the mouth, they will eat that one. Okay. So more acid will produce. So if you eat more chocolate and sweets, that time the decay will start, because so that bacteria present in the mouth, they will eat that one, they will produce some acids. So that time tooth decay. So at that time the saliva that is present in the mouth, its pH is going to reduce. It means it is fall down. So less than a 5.5 it is there. So that time the pH range less than a 5.5 it is there. So that time what will happen there? Tooth decay will start. Because acid content is more now. So 5.5 means it is acid or base.
Acid.
So in the pH reading, pH scale reading, then it shows the value 5.5. Reading showing 5.5 means it is acid. So less than 5.5 means, see, there are more acid will present in the saliva, in the mouth, is it? So to reduce that one, so if pH less than a 5.5, so that time what will happen, there more acid will produce, there more acid content is there in that saliva, that time tooth decay will start there. So we have to neutralize that acid. So what you will do there to neutralize that one? Base you have to use there, is it? Base you should use there. So toothpaste that acts as a base. Toothpaste, so that is a basic in nature. Toothpaste is a basic in nature. Okay, that's why after every meal you should brush our teeth. So we can't do that one, because in morning once we will do that, and next in the night, after meals, so that time you can, before going to bed, you can brush our teeth, is it? So that will keep the teeth, will protect the teeth from the tooth decay, is it? Tooth decay, because our teeth is made up of what? Teeth is made up of what? Calcium. Yes, calcium phosphate. Tooth enamel is there, that is made up of calcium phosphate. So it is the hardest material. See, that even though it is the hardest material, that also tooth decay will take place. Tooth decay, when it will take place, it will eat more sweets and chocolates. So more acid will be released there. The time the bacteria release the more acid, saliva become acidic in nature. So we have to reduce that one. You have to come into the neutralize. You have to neutralize that one. So what you have to do that? The time after every meal you should brush our teeth. Is it? So keep it in mind. Okay, that is a use of the pH. And the last one. So if honey bee bites on your skin, there what will happen there? Pain. So what is the reason? Because that honeybee it will release one acid. Okay, formic acid. Yes, formic acid will release there. Formic acid. So because of that reason, to protect from opposite. So they thought that they are doing something to that honeybee. So we want to protect. Is it? So that time it will bite there. So that time it will release the acid. Release the acid. Okay, that is the formic acid. So how to neutralize that one? By adding the baking soda. Here baking soda. So where it will bite there, if you put the baking soda, it will neutralize it. It means it will give relief from the pain. It will give relief from the pain. Pain will reduce. So acid reacts with the base. So it will neutralize it. Neutralizes the acids.